bidet. Finally. Good Lord. What did I lose? 3 in a row? You were 4-1 in Josh Spiegel's Time Machine Trivia. It's really become a cornerstone of the program. And I finally pulled off my second victory out of 6 games yesterday. Final score being, if I could pull it up here real quick, bitty bing bang boom, 193-52 was the final score.
Yeah, I mean, even if I had gotten it right, I did the math while driving home yesterday. I didn't wager enough to win anyway.
The answer
was Kathy Bates, and I said something else.
Glenn Close. I stole your bit from the last game.
Yeah, I remember that. That was when you...
So even if I would have wagered all my points, you would have beaten me by 1 point.
1 point. That move last time, I wanted a taste of revenge. Even if you had it right, I wanted to hit you with that.
What was it again? The move that he did...
The last time he won.
Yeah, that's right.
He just bet amount of points to where even if I had gotten it right, which I think I might have,
he beat me by one point.
Yeah, that's the Jeopardy move. Yeah. It's a Jeopardy move.
You do the math and you just wager enough to beat the other person by 1 point.
I tried to pull the same thing, and luckily God shined on this dog's ass, and I won, so we still need to come up with a punishment, and some have been chewed on, bandied about. I think the first one we came up with, 410-338-1098, call, text, love to hear your thoughts, give us some ideas. The first one, I believe, was the Tiger Bomb. On the...
on the balls.
On the unmentionables. Keith, where are we going to put the Tiger Bomb?
Bofa D's Nuts.
We're thinking about putting it there.
Yep.
I think another one was possibly suggested of the double mustache. Someone sent me a link to the double mustache. I'm sorry, I can only see your eyes. Let me just get that facial hair.
Really do.
I don't think you can.
I don't even shave this. This just doesn't come in.
Doesn't
right
grow.
Here.
Okay, so that's out. We can't do the double mustache. That's gone. Another fun one I really liked was the perm.
Perm is a great one. Somebody's saying frosted tips.
Frosted tips. I would take JC Chavez. I would love that if you got your boy band on.
Needs to get a pair of lips with the words Justin's bitch tattooed on my ass.
That's a little extreme.
And it's permanent.
No. This stuff's got to be embarrassing but temporary. Maybe if they're this, because this was a season finale to Time Machine Trivia. It'll return in the fall, we think, right around football season. But if there was ever to be a series finale, like one last one, then we'll think about something permanent. But for now.
This was a good one, too. And I think this person saw this where I saw it. I saw it online the other day. I guess some guy lost a bet with his buddies, and he had to take an inflatable doll on a date.
Like a Lars and the Real Doll? That's okay. Yeah, put a big check mark next to that box.
I go to a bar and I just sit there with like an inflatable.
And Miles has to come with
woman.
You and film it from a distance.
Mm-hmm.
Like we could just go to High Tops or one of our friends' restaurants, and you can't. And if anybody asks, you have to refer to her as like a real person. Like this is Belinda. No, what's going on with the doll, man? I'm sorry, you mean Belinda? Like, you have to acknowledge them. Like, you're an insane person.
I think, like, if I do that, I would even probably go viral because so many people in the restaurant would be snapping creeper photos and posting them. Like, look at this guy. Out with it.
Okay, so I just went
blow
out.
Up doll.
It was date night with the wife. And while we're waiting for our appetizer, we noticed this tall Italian guy in the back was giving this blow-up doll smooches and trying to feed her calamari. Yeah, like, you have bruschetta, and you're just trying to force it into her big open mouth.
I'm down.
That's funny. Sean Grody suggested
one.
His was, because we're doing Tiki Lee's. Tiki Lee's next Friday. Shout out. It's going to be July 9th. We want to see you there. 5 to 10 broadcast doors are at 6. Shootout on theriver.com for more info. I guess they're building a pool there.
Yeah.
And the thing should be done by then. Mm. And the pool's going to be in the... like the main area. So you can like swim and drink. Listen, Tiki Lee, I love you, but man, have that thing watched this summer. Have that thing lifeguarded up this summer. I could see somebody getting a couple of daiquiris in and deciding to do a full cannonball in clothes, or a lot of people getting pushed into that thing against their will.
He was saying that one member of the show gets to pick the other's bathing suit, and they spend the majority of the broadcast in the water. Taking advantage of the Tiki Lee's environment. Like, do we unveil the punishment or do the punishment at Tiki Lee's? Like, if you were to get a perm, the perm is revealed at Tiki Lee's.
Yeah.
You do it the day before, you show up there, and then there you go. I kind of like having a reveal at Tiki Lee's. Okay, I think that could be fun. So far, my two favorites, you get a perm, you got to show it at Tiki Lee's, everyone's taking photos with you, another reason to get them there. And I really like the doll.
Well, someone's saying a perm slash mullet hybrid. You want me to do that?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Very much. Yes.
I can either keep the top straight. Well, I can't perm the back because the back is not long enough. I could perm the top and then shave it into like a makeshift mullet.
Would you search?
I feel bad even. It's my punishment. You guys have to decide.
But you let me kind of join in on discussion before. Okay. Yes. Oh, man, you shouldn't have lost. Do you remember what The Rock looked like when he debuted?
Yes, of course.
Rocky Maivia with the pube patch on top?
Yeah.
I want that.
I can do that.
If you could do the Rocky Maivia and you've got that stupid, like, blue and green streamer around his neck, okay, that's a little much. But if we can do the 1990s, God, I think it was like 94.
Tight curl.
Just a snug, greasy perm up top.
Yeah.
Let's get some suggestions what we should do. Scott Reardon's Time Machine Trivia Punishment. Let's go to the phones. A lot of people checking in. They want to see you go through stuff. Adam, Perry Hall, what do you think?
I want to see him get pepper sprayed.
Oh.
Ooh.
It would be brief.
Dang.
It would be brief. It'd be over within an hour. You wouldn't have to dress as JoJo for a week or have thousands of people look at you as the turbo slut.
I'm just going
to
sit here. You tell me my punishment.
I feel bad about pepper spraying my boy. It's one of those things where I want you to be embarrassed, but I don't want you to be in pain. Adam, we're going to TBD that one. Thank you, buddy.
Adam, F you.
Yeah, right in the you-know-what. Let's talk to Glenn. I'm not opposed to this. This is embarrassment, not pain. Glenn, what's up?
Hey, what's going on?
What's up?
So I think Scott should have to do a 30 or 60 minute set at Magoobie's Joke House stand-up routine or a full body wax.
I don't have a lot of body hair, so that's really
not
a big
deal. Yeah, he's pretty smooth.
Pretty smooth.
I could chew on the idea. I mean, I got some shows coming up. That would kind of benefit me. If I put you on the bill doing 20, that is a draw like an MF-er. I would fill a place up.
Mm-hmm.
If you were to do 20 minutes of stand-up, I will absolutely chew on that idea. I like that.
Okay.
But it's not like a 5-minute set. I mean, a 20-minute set is a long time. 30 minutes too long.
I know. Like
60 minutes way too long. 20 minutes?
People work a whole year to get 60.
Yeah, people work. I didn't have 20 minutes in my first 2 years. Okay, like that one. We're going to put that in the hopper. Let's go to Dave in Kingsville. God, all kinds of great ideas. Scott lost Time Machine Trivia. What should the punishment be, Dave?
Well, I like to see his hairless body, so maybe he needs to wear a string bikini every morning when he walks his dog for about a week.
About a week, walking the dog in a string bikini through the neighborhood.
Okay.
I mean, does that have long-lasting implications in your standing in the neighborhood?
No.
He also lives across from blind people.
I live across the street from a school.
Yeah. Scott. Hey, we should get Scott on the sex offender registry. That'd be hilarious. Yeah, we should put Scott directly in the eyes of the FBI. I don't think we could do that because, yes, a bunch of kids would see you outside walking the dog.
Hey, Shoemaker, F you.
Morning, kids. Let's go to Honcho / Rico. Westminster, what's up, man?
I like this one.
Morning, fellas.
Morning.
Hey, y'all. So this actually happened to me when I lost a bet back in the day. Give Scott the fryer tuck, man. The hair on the sides and the back to make a Mach 5 on top.
Oh, the cul-de-sac?
Yeah.
The hair cul-de-sac? Part of me, I'm okay with the perm. We've done a lot of hair stuff.
Yeah.
Between the Abe Lincoln beard, we've done the Infinibeard, the JoJo Siwa wig. It's the only thing that I'm hung up on about the perm, because we've done a lot of hair stuff.
Okay, just throwing this out. Don't know if this is good or not. Just rapping. Just shooting the breeze.
Couple of kids.
What about if Scott had to wear, like, giant clown shoes? Like, you know what I'm talking about?
Ronald,
like,
McDonald those clown shoes?
Yeah, like gigantic clown shoes.
They're so inconvenient, and he can't take them off. You have to drive with those things.
See, the only problem I have with these drive kind of punishments, and this is just me as, like,
downstairs,
a producer, is it's funny for people to see if I'm out and about, but then how do you translate to the on-air?
Where's
air?
The on-air payoff?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna. God, I love the idea of you wearing clown shoes, just big ass clown shoes.
What if we have? I mean, I'm not trying to sway this, but could we do a perm live at Tiki Lee's?
Can anybody bring the stuff out there to do it?
Like the whole morning. That'd be like, I'd be in the rollers, and I'd be.
I like it. Look like Big Worm.
And then, like, 9 o'clock hour, the rollers.
The rollers come off, know. And everyone's just like, yeah.
That's a better on it. It's a more better on air component.
Yeah, as far as the on air components, I think the perm reveal, like, at Tiki Lee's.
We couldn't do the. I mean,
the perm reveal at Tiki
Lee's. Pepper spray would be good, but, like, that needs to be outside. I need to be. I mean, I guess we can.
That's a morning. That's a morning ruiner, though. That's the thing, is once you did that, you're done for that morning show. Because I kind of need you the rest of the show. You're sort of integral to the program. If you do that, that's over. I'm thinking the stand-up, because there can be a build-up to it. I got shows coming up we can tack you on to. Lickety-split. Wendy could get you set up. But a part of me for this first one at Tiki Lee's, I'm thinking the perm at Tiki Lee's, either done at Tiki Lee's or the reveal at Tiki Lee's. And then the question then is, how long do you keep it? You can't just, like...
No, no, it stays
it's permanent.
Until
it grows.
Yeah, it's a
but
permanent.
You can't shave it off or anything.
No, no, no,
okay.
No, 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 no.
Okay, so you would keep it until...
Yeah, 100%.
All right, Josh, how do you feel about that? A perm reveal at Tiki Lee's?
That's fine.
Okay,
and,
I think we got it.
We'll use clown shoes.
Done, we're going to use clown shoes.